It's time to meet your new Copilot UI. When you log into Office 365, the homepage itself has changed. In case you don't see this UI and you still see the old one, don't worry. Very soon, this will get updated. If you have free version of Copilot, you will simply see the Copilot chat. And if you have paid version, you will see two tabs, Work and Web. Work Copilot has access to all your data. Web does not have access to all the data. In either case, look for this icon, Enterprise Data Protection. This will appear only when you log in using your Office 365 ID. This ensures that whatever data you put here, whether it is in the free version or paid version, is safe and is not going to be used for training purpose. Let's go to chat. This is the Copilot chat. The paid version of Copilot can look at three places. One is all your data. Second is ChatGPT's general knowledge, and third is web content. So you can switch web content search on or off on a case-to-case basis. When you click on the plus sign, you can refer to files and other content as well. I can say, give me all the mails sent by this person or anything related to a particular meeting. You can refer to up to 5 items in the prompt. So here is a matrix which explains current capacities. This keeps changing, so check the latest documentation whenever you are watching the video. One common irritant is while adding files, you can't see the file in this list. This list comes from recently opened files. So if the file is there, but you haven't opened it recently, it will not appear here. But don't worry, you can click on the OneDrive icon, and now you can see all your files in OneDrive, Teams, and SharePoint. Open this pane to reveal shared files, favorites, files by people, files across meetings, and files in Teams and SharePoint. And what if you have files on local drive? Click on this up arrow button, upload from device, choose the file. A copy of the file will first get uploaded to OneDrive, and then Copilot will work on it. So let's see how to use this chat. I'm going to ask a simple prompt. Give me a list of all versions of Excel. When I want to change the topic, ask about a completely different question, then I must remember to select start a new chat. The next thing is, where is my chat history? Chat history is conversations. So if I open it, I'll see recent prompts. But if I want to see a prompt which I had used earlier, long back, then go to all conversations and search. This gives you a list of all the prompts you have used ever since you started using Copilot. Now let's see another aspect of this. I got this output, but I can't edit it. I can't share it with others. Here we have edit in pages. Pages means loop pages. When I click on this, it's going to create a new page in loop and put all this output here. I can edit this. I can share it with my team. Go to page link. By default, it is existing access. Obviously, at this stage, nobody has access other than me. So go to settings, select people I choose, specify the name of person, allow them to edit or view, and if required, put an expiration date, and then say apply. Now it'll copy the link and send it to your team. So now this page is editable by your team members, and those team members do not need Copilot license because this is just a loop page. Now I'm going to create a new chat and ask it to list all versions of PowerPoint. I want to append it to the Excel page. To do that, click on this button, choose Add to Recent Page, and there you'll see the Excel page, and now this got added below the page. Now let's look at a brand new feature called Notebooks. You create a new notebook and give it some references or files, up to 20 items. And once you do that, it's going to work on those files or those references and give you answers. To save time, I have already created a notebook. This is efficiency SOPs. So in this notebook, I have given 20 references of SOPs. These are Word files explaining how to use Microsoft products efficiently. Now, before you start asking questions, you can also give custom instructions. And these instructions will be applied for every prompt which you provide in this notebook. And now I'm going to say list SOPs. So here it is. It has gone through my data, and it has listed exactly what each file does. It has segregated them based on the category of work. Another amazing feature it has is, based on whatever references you have given, it'll actually create a podcast with two people talking to each other and explaining whatever is there in the references. So let's play this audio and listen to it.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to today's overview.
So even though it uses capabilities like ChatGPT or DALL-E, your information isn't exposed for training, correct?
Exactly. Another smart trick is automating the process of sending split emails based on Excel data.
So it created a 9-minute podcast based on the content which I had uploaded. Now that brings us to the last topic, the most popular topic called agents. When you open this, you may see a list of agents based on what we have used in the past. But if you are coming here for the first time, it's a good idea to click on All Agents. Scroll down and look at Built by Microsoft. And down below, there are more featured ones. Researcher and Analyst are currently in beta. You should get them soon. I'm going to show you only one of them, Prompt Coach. First time when you open it, it'll ask you to add. Now I have already used it, so it's asking me to open it. If you find a particular agent useful, you can also pin it. I'm going to give a prompt which I've already used, and I'm going to ask this prompt coach to improve my prompt. So now it's explaining what it is trying to do, because each prompt has a goal, context, source, and expectations. So now it is asking me specific questions. Why am I listing all the versions? If you want to give the next answer, please don't press enter, because enter will submit it. Shift enter will go to next line. So am I working on a project? Yes, I'm creating. And now that I have provided additional information, so here is the final prompt. So I started with a one-liner prompt, and Prompt Coach helped me make a better prompt out of it. Now it's not going to give you those features. Remember, this is not Copilot Chat. This is Prompt Coach. Now you can copy paste this into chat and then you'll get the desired answer. To use any agent quickly, click on the plus sign and choose this, or simply type @ and now select the desired agent. Now, although I am in chat, I am talking to the idea coach. So I ask for ideas for interactive things, and it is giving me multiple ideas. We are using ready-made agents, but that's not all. You can create your own agents. When you click on it, it will open Copilot Studio, and there you can actually build agents yourself. You can create simple agents by providing content and knowledge and create a AI-based chatbot. Or if you're a developer, you can connect to business systems and create task-oriented agents or autonomous agents as well. But that is for another video. Let's explore the create option. You can create images, design posters. Create a form comes from Microsoft Form. And if you click on more, banner comes from the Visual Creator. This is Word, PowerPoint, Excel. I'm going to show you quickly how to create an image. Describe what you want. Choose a style. If you have created a brand kit, use that. Otherwise, choose any theme and then decide what is the aspect ratio. And now click on Create. So here is the image, but that's not all. Unlike other tools, this gives you full-fledged editor. You can manipulate the image in various ways. So this is similar to Canva, but this is a part of Copilot at no extra cost. It also has a video creator. It can even accept a PowerPoint file and create a video from it. But I'm going to ask it to create a video for professional presentation skills. It analyzes, decides the style, creates the script, finds the visuals, and gives you a video which you can edit further. It created a 2-minute video in less than a minute. I'm going to play it so that you can hear what it did.
Mastering the art of presentation is a game changer for your career. But ensure they complement your speech rather than distract from it. Finally, handle questions with confidence. Listen carefully of your presentation.
Is this the final video? Probably not. So that's why we have Edit in Clipchamp, where the entire video is now completely editable. Individual visuals, you have text templates, background music, which is royalty free, stock videos, stock images, graphics, transitions, and finally, refine the content exactly the way you want. After you're done, click on export and you can get a fine 4K video. Let's look at search. I'm just typing one word called sales and look at what it did. Searched across all these things, all files which I have access to, SharePoint, OneDrive, Teams, everything on Microsoft platform. It also looks at all my messages, means email messages and Teams, which includes chat, channels and meetings. It also gives you access to pictures. Look at this picture. The word sales is not there at all in the file name. It's inside the picture. And finally, apps are just Office apps, part of Microsoft 365. If you click on all apps, you will see the entire list. And if you have admin access, you will see this option, which will take you to the admin portal. Copilot is not just available as chat. It's available in all these tools. To choose the correct tool, go to the Copilot inside that app and then use it effectively. So I'm sure you found this useful. Try it out and share it with as many people as you can. Do let me know your comments, feedback, and give me ideas for more videos. So that's it for now. See you soon. Thank you.